What? What? What is this madness? I don't even. What? Yeah, sure, whatever. So yeah, guys, this is Tropico 4. Apparently, a sequel to Tropico 3 that I never heard about. This is a game. What is going on? Well, this game looks interesting. Hello everyone! I'm here with a new series for the channel, Time to Level Up, that I'm gonna call the Free Weekend Game Deal. Oh my god, that's so original, isn't it? Well, it's a good name for the series that I'm gonna try to do. So here we have the Free Weekend for this week. There is Tropico 4 that is currently available on Steam for free during the weekend, because that's what this series is all about, because if it wasn't free, it wouldn't exist. Now that there is out of the way, let's get started with this. I messed around with the options. You can see here that your general options, you can use this, you can use this. Hotkeys for in the case that you want to play this as a RTS game. Not me, really. This is most likely like SimCity, but yeah. Put everything on high, and yeah, let's get started. But there is something interesting with the description of this game that I found on Steam. Let's read it, shall we? So right here we have the description that there is on the game page on Steam, and it says, "The world is changing and Tropico is moving with the times. Geographical power is rising and falling, and the world market is dominated by new players with new demand and offers. And you, as El Presidente, face a whole new set of challenges. If you are to triumph over your naysayers, you will need to gain as much support from your people as possible. Your decisions will shape the future of your nation, and more importantly, the size of your offshore bank account. Tropico 4 expands the gameplay of the previous game with new political additions, including more superpowers to negotiate with, along with the ability to elect ministers into power to help get you more controversial policies passed. But remember to keep your friends close and your enemies closer, as everyone has an agenda. Your political middle will be thoroughly tested, as new natural disasters will have the populace clamoring for you and your cabinet to help them recover from some of the worst modern nature can dish out." This is basically the description of this game. I can tell you that from it seems kind of weird to play the game as you have to manage the city and your own things as a polit. That's a politic. So let's go on to the tutorial first and see what it's all about.
"I have decided to take up politics. I am sure that soon I will rule Tropico. For the benefit of future historians, I have started writing this journal. Here, I will keep a record of my rise to power and my struggle to make Tropico the best nation in the world. First, I have to learn how to rule an island nation. The famed Generalissimo Santana has decided to take me under his wing and teach me the basics. My first goal is to learn how to navigate around my island, how to examine buildings and citizens, and how to order new constructions."
Good thing that there is voice acting in this game, because sometimes reading things is not for people who like reading things. So I don't really know what this is. Mission score 000, 70%, 0. Press, Tropico has top secret spy satellite. Even the cadres and Arisons Santana has a new prodigy. Sure. This is exactly like SimCity.
You can't do any.
Well,
There's nothing quite like being in command and holding the reins of power. There's no doubt about it. It's fun to be number one.
There's nothing quite like being in command and holding the reins of power. There's no doubt about it. It's fun to be number one. Remaining in power, however, is not an easy task. You have to cope with the demands of all the political factions of your island and make sure that they will support you if an election is coming. On top of that, there are foreign powers. If they like you, they will give you foreign aid, and if you anger them, they will invade you, and you definitely don't want that. Explore the island for additional tasks to learn more about politics. Resolve all tasks on this island to finish the tutorial. Sure. Well, you can see that you have a city. Well, if you can call this a city, I call it more like 3 buildings and exclamation points. And some people. So, you see that the graphics are pretty good for a game that has to render a lot of things. The only thing that I don't like about it right now is this camera that I can't really get used to it, since you'll be getting too close to building sometimes, as I can predict. If it were from a top view, I think I would be good with it, but I just can't go through it. It's weird. So here we have a palace that seemingly is for producing this. There are only 4 workers here. I think this is for police. You can't change that. Oh, there you go. This changes the camera for a much better view. Now it is much better. I see. Oh, this is the guy coming to work, and he comes by foot. Isn't that good?
There's nothing
no,
quite like
that's
being
not what
car.
I want. Oh,
the
there we go.
The is your best friend. It contains all the information you'll ever need. Let's take a look.
Oh, so all I had to do was click the exclamation points. Seems basic enough, and I'm so dumb that I can't follow simple orders. The almanac is displayed in several sections, each dealing with a specific subject, such as economy, trade, factions, etc. Open the almanac by clicking on the button above the mini map and navigate to the factions tab. Sure. That's a task.
Politics in Tropico are dominated by 8 factions. Communists, capitalists, religious, militarists, intellectuals, environmentalists, nationalists, and loyalists. Each faction has its own political ideals and demands.
Most of your citizens are members of one of more or more of these factions. The citizens' political affiliation. The city's political affiliations define the respect happiness. So that the loyalists fashion the almanac to view their demands. Is there an Oh! Sure.
The respect of a given faction defines how content that faction is. If the faction's respect is low, it will make problems. If the respect is high, it will support you in the next elections.
So, you right-click to get this build menu up. I think you can do it another way. Let me see. No, you cannot. You right-click to build this thing up, you go to Entertainment, Childhood Museum, and you just place it somewhere. Let's place it over here. Looks like a good place. And you're gonna start build. You're gonna start to build, and everyone's gonna be happy. Look at this guy. Manuel Gutierrez. Cool. Oh, look at this worker. Oh, look at this. Oh, really? Only one guy's gonna... Oh my god, it's so fast. Only one guy's gonna work on this? He's just digging pure concrete. This guy is badass. What is his name? Varinia Ramos. Dude, you deserve a better salary. Oh my god, where is he? There he is. I need to... Too fast. Oh, there is another guy. What are you gonna do?
Buenos dias.
De Anita Hernandez. You're a female. Good. Good to know. Good to know. There are female workers here too. There is something. Cool. And it shows this, which is pretty interesting. It shows her family tree. And there you go, the thing is done. Just because of two workers, that is interesting, isn't it? What?
Well done, Presidente. Thanks to your efforts, the loyalist demand has been satisfied and their respect has increased.
To view the number of supporters, check the factions entry in the almanac. What is this? What is this? Why is there a icon that doesn't look good spinning around here? Who is this guy? I don't know. Almanac back again. We can see that the loyalists have 14 supporters, while the others have 16, 6, 16, 11, 8, 17, and 10. Which just seems good enough. There is a childhood museum. What are you talking about? So what? Why now? What? Well, sure, I completed the task.
I find foreigners very annoying. Unfortunately, from time to time, you have to deal with the so-called superpowers.
Is it lagging much more now? Oh, look at this. There are workers coming to it now. With trucks. Cargo trucks. These guys are ballers. Let's see if that girl is still here. Or that guy. Do I remember his name? Wow, you're 55? And you're building things? You're good.
I have learned all that Generalissimo Santana can teach me. Politics is a dangerous art and I have to master it to remain in power. I must keep a watchful eye on the local factions, improve the respect of the larger factions first by satisfying their demands and completing faction tasks. If a faction's respect is low, it will cause problems and won't support me in the next elections. Maintaining good relations with foreign powers will grant me more foreign aid and other benefits. I have to avoid angering the US and the USSR, or I might find myself out of a job. Finally, I must remember to set aside something for myself in my Swiss bank account.
Pretty good. Pretty good. And it was 70% difficulty. I don't even want to know the 100%.
I have decided to take up politics.
That's really good. There is a tutorial. The tutorial was pretty long because I was lost most of the time. Let's go to the campaign and see what it's all about. It must be a piece of cake. Fast forward. Well, this game has been interesting so far. I've been really liking it. I mean, it's like SimCity. It's exactly like SimCity, but it's different in some way. This is SimCity with a different name, basically. I've never played SimCity that much to know really the differences between those, but it's really interesting. I really look forward to getting a little bit further into this. Oh god. So, I'm gonna do a post commentary from now on forward, because I don't really talk while I'm gaming. So I'm gonna tell you what I thought about the game after playing for like 3 hours and such. I'm gonna tell you it's a pretty good game. I've noticed that there are some things in the game like that are exactly like SimCity, as with you gotta satisfy people, you gotta do things and stuff. This game can be compared to SimCity in so many ways, but I'm gonna try to make that to keep that comparison to the least amount possible, because I don't like comparing games. So, you can see that you can interact with the citizens in this game with some options there that I didn't even dare to touch it because I was paying attention to the most basic things of the game. But if you take a deep look, it's a pretty good game, but it's so slow paced. It's really slow paced. It takes a lot of time for you to go somewhere, and the tasks just keep coming towards you at some times. In the meanwhile, you try to accomplish some tasks that take time, and you just can't really do much stuff with it. There were some parts in the game where you start. Let's say that you start in a small city with no electric power, and then the power plant is like $20,000, and you can't really afford it at the beginning. The city would be just fine with it with no power plant, so you can survive with no problems with that. And let's see what else. Like, the main objective that you need to do in this game is to satisfy the most amount of factions you can. The more satisfied they are, the better it is for you. The problem is, like in any game that is this style, you will keep losing money, because unless you're really good at your place, as the president of the place, you can't really make a profit that often. You will receive some money from exporting stuff once in a while, but it's not every time, and in the meanwhile you'll be losing money. So you need to be very careful with your money, because you won't really have that much. Although there are some ways where you can get money, like you can print money for real. You can print money, but that is bad. That will raise inflation. We have some good amount of money. Yeah, looks good so far. And we're finally exporting tobacco. The funny thing is, we have a tobacco farm right beside a church. What is this? But you really need to organize your city well, because that is the thing you want to do most. And there is not much things that happen in this game that I can commentate about. You just gotta administrate your city and do the best you can with it. Although there are some times that natural disasters will happen and they are gonna get in your way a lot, and you don't really want that to happen, because I got a tornado that happened with me, but that happened after I stopped recording, and it destroyed a lot of things. It's even a troll tornado, where it just comes back to your city when it seems like it's going away. That's a tornado for you guys. It comes back to your city like a magnet. But the thing is, there is not much to this stuff. Although the hotkeys are pretty good. If in the case that you want to do something like when you're going to build something, the game pauses, and it's gonna pause constantly, and the time won't go by. So you really want for the time to go by as quickly as you can, because it's kind of a slow game, as I said before. So if you want, you can set your hotkeys to build some stuff. But there is basically that. There's not much I can talk about it. So, after all I've said, I'm gonna divide all the things that I said in pros and cons so you can really see what it's all about. So, as pros, we have the game looks like SimCity. I said that I didn't want to do many comparisons, but this is a good comparison. The game looks like SimCity, and we're all familiarized to how SimCity works. Another pro is the game is simple in the beginning. It has a learning curve, and that is something easy to learn if you are going to play the game more, for a bit more time, which is pretty good. And another thing is that it's the learning curve is easy to learn if you're into the game. I mean, some stuff doesn't seem quite in their place, but it is pretty easy to understand. So if you really are interested in playing the game, it's pretty easy to learn about it. Now, the cons are, sometimes the game just doesn't wanna do the things you want. As an example, you build a lot of construction sites for the workers to live on, and they just don't go work on the buildings as you are constructing, and that is really annoying since the game is already really slow, and that makes the game go even slower. Although you can set the priority of buildings, of constructing stuff, and the workers will go there, but it seems like they only go to those buildings if they are set to high priority, because if they aren't, they just don't go there. Another thing that is a con is the music. The music is good for like the first 30 minutes. It's like three tracks that repeat themselves. After that, it gets annoying. It gets in your head. That tropical music. It's good for the theme of the game, but it gets in the way sometimes because it's simply annoying after some time. If there were a little more tracks, or simply there were no music at all, like there is in SimCity, another comparison that I'm doing, which is I didn't want to do, but I had to do, will be good. So if you are getting annoyed by the music, just mute the game and play some of your own music. So that is all that there is for pros and cons of the game that I could notice after playing for 3 hours. And I'll let you guys with my outro that isn't in post commentary. So, yeah. Here it comes. Anytime now. Oh, that sounds so bad. Okay, right now, let's go. If you like the game, you can play it. It's really, really good. I've been showing some of the things, and I mean, it's pretty. It's been pretty good so far. Oh, I can hire these guys. But yeah, I need to hire all the ministers, but I can't really do that without money.
According to early reports, a fight has started between the Minister wannabes.
Judging by the number of applications we received, this means that Tropico is officially in a state of civil war.
But yeah, the game is pretty good. If you want to play it, it's free on Steam. Or it was, because this video is probably going up on Monday. But this game is pretty fun. If you want, you can buy it. It's pretty interesting. It's like SimCity. If you don't want to wait for SimCity 5 to come out, because it's probably going to come out someday, like Half-Life 3, you can buy this game. It's probably cheap. It's like $14, I think, without any sort of promotion. But yeah, if you want to buy it, you can go there. We have a lot of things. I didn't really go into many of the things that this game has to offer, like online features and such. But I think that's the minimal stuff, because yeah, that's not really necessary for a game like this. If you want to go online, you can. I don't really know what the online feature works, but it's probably on a way like sharing stuff. I don't know, managing a city that other people can roam around. I have no idea, but I should build a world here, because god damn it, these guys don't make anything. Tropico 4, a pretty fun game. Looks like SimCity. If you like SimCity, you're gonna like this game. You need to manage your city and stuff. It's pretty good. It's something that you should look forward to if you want to buy this game. It's pretty interesting. And as always, it's hard to manage your
money.
City.
That's what I want. Am I right, Mike?
So yeah. Go buy it now if you want. I recommend it. I recommend it. It's a pretty good game. There's also this radio station that keeps talking stuff like it is on GTA 4. And one citizen became a criminal. That is great. We have one burglar on our city. So yeah, it's been pretty good. And this is it for the free weekend game deal of this week. What is gonna be next? I don't know. But I'll see you guys on the next weekend. Until there, have fun!